Merry Christmas, my queens and kings. It's your girl Crystal back at it with another video. And since the year is ending, I wanted us to reflect on the things we have learned this year. So I actually compiled a list, probably like 20 things that I've learned this year, plus what my friends have learned this year as well. So stay tuned and let me know, bro, if you relate and you've learned this as well. So the first thing on the list that April, my friend, has mentioned, she actually sent me a bunch, which I will mention her more later in the video. The first thing is appreciate the small things. I feel like this year, we've realized how blessed we actually are. We are more blessed than we actually realize. Number two that I've learned this year is we also have a voice. A voice that won't go unheard. It's crazy how even during this pandemic, so many things have been going on around this world, so many movements, so many issues, and usually people stay quiet about these things because majority of the time people think, you know, one small action, one person won't really make a difference, but we are actually more powerful than we think. I mean, there's still so many things that we need to learn and grow from, but I think this year especially our voices have been heard, our voices have been loud this year, especially during the time of George Floyd and the Black Lives Matter movement. So many people have used their voices, have used their platforms, whether big or small, to really just open up our eyes to the issue that has been there for years. Even though it's like a little late in the game, I'm happy that people are now realizing, especially myself, how big of a voice we actually have and how powerful we really are. The upside of social media is the amount of power we have just through the touch of our fingers as well. So that's amazing. Number three, unplugging from the world and everyone around you is normal. It is okay to do nothing, especially during this pandemic. Like, I know a lot of people have been using that time wisely and just, you know, being so motivated and determined to get things done. I feel like I've learned that it's also normal to not be able to do these things, to be in a slump and to just be in your fields and not do anything and wanting to just separate and isolate yourself from everything around you, dwelling in your feelings and choosing to do nothing. I think it's normal and okay to do. And honestly, I think it's healthy. Sometimes we need those days, to be honest, to keep ourselves sane. So number four, my friend Jenny has mentioned. So this is what she said. So the biggest thing I have learned this year is not to take anything or anyone for granted. Because COVID made me realize that life was amazing before and we gotta keep working harder and appreciate what we have. Girl, I feel you on this. She also said, I also have learned that relationships take time, patience, communication, and commitment. Doesn't matter how long you know someone, there's always more to learn about that person. Honestly, I can't relate because I don't really have a person that I have for a long time. So lastly, she mentioned, and sad to say, but I also learned that people are selfish. COVID really shows us who are the people you don't want to be around. I totally agree. For me, one of the things that really bothered me this year, where I realized that yeah, there are selfish people in this world, which is sad because I try to stay hopeful for people and humanity in general, but I realized how many people have been selfish, like especially the whole COVID situation. Like, you know, there have been anti-mask protesting and all that, like anti-lockdown protesting. Usually the main reason that they use is that the death isn't as significant compared to other deaths before this year and stuff like that. Like, there's only a small death rate, small percentage of deaths happening because of COVID. And I feel like people are getting lost in numbers. Like, people are not numbers. Like, even if it was like 1%, 0.5% death rate of COVID, like, those are still people that have died and people's families have been affected through that. Those deaths still matter no matter how small of a percentage the death rate is. Personally, for me, that's what I believe. And I don't see people as numbers. So I care for that small percentage that people tend to use as a reason to not be in lockdown or to not wear a mask. And I wish people would take it as seriously, just because I've also been through it. I've known people who've gone through it. I've known their symptoms. I am blessed to not have experienced anything worse or have experienced someone dying because of COVID, which I am praying for the people that are going through it and for the people that know is going through it, that they recover. But it's not something to be taken lightly, for sure. So number seven, because of this whole COVID situation, I realized I've learned to give time to the people I love. You never know what will happen in any situation, shape, or form. And if you don't give that time to them, like, just check how they're doing and stuff. Like, you never know when's the next time you'll see them. And this year have made me realize the importance of, you know, the people that I love around me, checking up on them and spending much time, whether it's virtually or if I'm able to, you know, in person, and just cherishing the moments that I have with them. Number eight, you can't please everyone. Everyone has a unique mind of their own, you know, everyone has different perspectives, different beliefs, different values, and which we should respect in general. But because we're all so different from one another, like, there are things that we don't like about someone else's beliefs or what their perspective is on things and stuff like that. So taking out that pleasing everyone mindset will really help you to just get through life, because I am a people pleaser. I don't like hurting someone, or I just don't like disappointing people and stuff like that. But I've learned to realize that I am not in control of what they believe or how they perceive me as, no matter how true I am to myself, no matter how I try to present myself. You know, people will always have an opinion about it, and I just gotta accept it, because, like, I'm just wasting my time trying to please everyone when really you can't do that. Like, that's impossible. Not everyone's going to like you and believe in what you do. Also, you know, there are just natural trolls out there. Usually, like, when it comes to those situations where people have a negative thing to say about me, like, majority of the time I just, like, ignore it, because, you know, they're probably just trolling. Or I try to be more understanding, where, you know what, maybe this person's having a bad day and they wanted to just put that negativity that they have within themselves out on me, which is fine, because I've actually learned how to, like, deal with that and just be okay with it and not take it to heart as much. There are times where I do take it to heart, not gonna lie. But honestly, I just try to be more understanding and ignore it. I don't like entertaining negativity. So when I see negativity around my social media or in my life, like, I choose to ignore it or just stray away from that, because I know how my mindset works. If I am always surrounded by negativity, it's just not healthy. It's not healthy for me to dwell on it. It's not healthy for me to entertain it as well. So, ignored. Number nine, care for yourself the way you would care for another. Honestly, it goes with saying, like, how can you take care of others when you can't even take care of yourself? Really, if you exude light in yourself, it'll be spreading light towards others as well. That's how I see it, at least. So number 10 is another friend of mine, which would like to be anonymous, so I am not going to say this person's name, but the person said that, I've learned not to give all of myself to the person I love, that I need to spare some love for myself too, that I'm worth so much more than I thought and stronger than I thought. I feel like you shouldn't give your whole self to another person, because that can be very draining. I'm still in the process of learning that too, because I'm just a naturally giving person, but I do believe that you should spare some love for yourself and shouldn't lose yourself in a relationship. So I think that was me before. I think I've lost myself in relationships, even friendships sometimes. So I'm learning my worth. You know, really know your worth when it comes to these things, because yeah, it's good to give to others, but knowing your worth, like your boundary as to, okay, this is too much, like I'm losing myself, I'm being drained. Like when you're with someone, like they shouldn't be draining you, they should be like reflected upon all other aspects in your life, you know, like being motivated and just positive to do other things. So number 11, there are people who genuinely care about you and there are other people that are just there for convenience. That's what I've learned. You kind of realize that you're kind of friends with people because they're just conveniently there at that time, or it's just like because you're friends with their friends, you have mutual friends. Usually that's why you're friends with them or why you consider them a close friend of yours. But this year I've really learned who are really there for me, I guess you would say, who genuinely check up on me on a daily. Not saying that you should, because people go through their own personal things, but I've just realized the people that I see them in my future for the rest of my life that are true homies, true A1s, the people that I love. And I'm happy with the friends that I have and I wouldn't change that for the world. Okay, so this is April. She like went off on her list. She gave me a list of things that she's learned. So number 12, she said, learning to be patient with myself and things in life. I'll end up where I'm supposed to be. So under that, she was like, to stop comparing my journey to other people's journey. People worked as hard as I did, and I shouldn't put myself down because I'm not achieving what I want to achieve in life, which is so true. Like, I am so used to comparing myself to other people's journeys. Like, and sometimes I feel like I do double the work, but it's not really shown as much as I want it to be. But I have to realize, like, everyone's different, everybody's different in terms of my fitness journey, of course. And I tend to dwell on that a lot, and like I try to get out of that mindset, but it's really hard. But it's definitely what I've learned, that I shouldn't be comparing to someone else's journey because it's so different than mine. She also went on saying, I'm not a failure because I'm not where I should be now. Trying not to give into the pressure. It's also helped me to be more grateful towards a lot of things and appreciate being in the present rather than keep thinking about what if for the future. So yeah, I've definitely learned that as well, like just being present in the moment, you know. We tend to dwell a lot in the past, and we also tend to think a lot about the future. I feel like I'm always like just thinking about, damn, I should not be where I'm supposed to be right now. Like, I am 25, I should be already achieving this in life, but you know what, it is what it is. Just be present to where you are now, because you can only control what's in the present moment. She also said, eliminating what doesn't help me evolve. So cutting relationships slowly with people who don't help me grow as a person. Honestly, COVID made me rethink people I'm connected to. Thinking about the positives and negatives and their values. Telling myself that it is okay to let go even though there was no negativity between the person and me. I totally agree. There doesn't always have to be something negative happening to really cut a person off. Sometimes you just know who's meant to be in your life and who's not, and it's okay to let those go. So she said, listening to what my mind and body feels. Not giving into pressure for things that are not in my interest or I feel like I'm forcing myself to do or enjoy. That kind of like ties into pleasing everyone. You tend to do things based off what other people like to do. even though you don't really enjoy it that much. I feel like we've realized time is short, you know, anything can happen in life. So do what you love to do, honestly, and don't be pressured into doing what everyone else is doing. So number 16, she also mentioned the importance of self-love and practicing it. So learning to manifest my negative energy into something positive so I'm not festering in it. Girl, I feel you on this. Self-love should always be practiced. I'm not perfect, even though like it seems that I'm a very confident person. I also struggle with self-love and I'm still learning each and every day of my life. I don't like dwelling on the negativity, as I said before, and I try to find the positive aspects in my life, in myself, and just focus more on that, because I feel like we should all be able to love ourselves. Like, it's weird how hard it is too, but I feel like this year people have really been practicing and showing the importance of self-love and reminding people how much of a boss they are. So I feel like this year it was a lot more so, you know, learning about ourselves and what we're capable of and how much we deserve in life, that negativity should not be in the picture at all, because we're actually pretty sick people. So, you know. So number 17, she also said learning to communicate what I feel to others rather than just hiding it and letting it sit. Oh my gosh, this has been definitely a learning curve. I usually tend to just keep things bottled up just because I don't want to bother a person. Like, in my head, I think it's not even a big deal, so why bring it up, when really, like, I feel like we should be able to communicate better towards people, especially towards the people that you see in your future, or, you know, friendships, genuine friendships and relationships and all that. Like, communication is key. I feel like when you're not afraid to say how you feel, that'll really open up and make your relationships, friendships even better. So I've learned to just say how I feel, not hide things, and also just be able to clearly explain myself further if they don't understand what I'm trying to say or how I'm trying to, like, let them know how I really feel and not be misinterpreted. So back to me. Number 18, we are much more creative and motivated than we think. Oh my gosh. This year, you know, like, I don't know about you guys, but we've been in constant lockdowns. We're still in lockdown, and it's extending even further over the New Year's and all that, even more stricter than ever. But let me tell you, this year, there are so many things that happened. Like, people have opened up businesses and just gone for it. Like, it's crazy how creative we actually are. When there's nothing else to do, literally, when you're in lockdown and you're in quarantine and there's nothing else to do, what better thing to do than to actually, you know, do shit, right? Like, people are more motivated than ever to get the things that they wanted to do forever and really manifest it into the world and make it into a reality. So that goes with my second point. Number 19, it's never too late to start on your goals or dreams. Oh my gosh. I have so many friends that have opened up their own businesses, whether it's food, clothes, you know, stickers, just like accessories and all that. Like, it is crazy how much people evolve. Obviously, I'm not there yet. I'm a late bloomer, but you know, it'll come out sooner or later, maybe next year or the year after. We'll see. I don't know. It depends on the whole finance thing. People just went for it, and that's amazing. So it comes to my last point. Never live your life out of fear. Usually what tends to hold us back to, you know, achieving our goals, our dreams, whatever, is the fear of failure, the fear of just not letting it become what we really wanted it to be. And because we're scared that it's not going to be what we expected, we just choose not to do it. Yeah, there's going to be a lot of, like, roller coasters and trial and error along the way, but like, that's the best part of any journey in general. So whatever goal you have, whether it's to lose 50 to 60 pounds or, you know, start your own business that you've been really passionate about and wanting to do for so long, but you're scared that no one will see it, trust the process. You know, trust in yourself. Believe in what you can actually achieve, because trust me, this year, if anything, no matter how much things have been thrown our way, that was very, very negative and could have really been detrimental, people turned it and switched it around and gave that biggest reverse Uno card, okay? Like, literally, they used that, you know, pandemic, that quarantine, that lockdown, all that, like, things that could really take a toll on us mentally, some people have turned it around and used that to be driven, used that to achieve what they wanted to achieve in life ever since they were little. This year pushed us to wanting to get shit done. Despite all of the negative events that happened this year, I've learned so much and I can't wait to bring it on to the next year, to be honest. I hope you guys learned something too. And if you did, please leave a comment down below on what are the things you've learned for 2020, because I know there are so many things that has happened in our lives that have been life-changing. By the way, let me know if you guys like the lighting, if it's too bright. Yeah, because your girl got a ring light. Shout out to that bestie for buying me a ring light as a gift. Love that. So obviously this is posted on Christmas Day. So for anyone who celebrates Christmas, Merry Christmas and happy holidays. I do have a lot of things planned. I did not do a monthly weigh-in just because, you know, nothing's changed. It's the holidays, you know, it's okay. And I feel like I'm only gonna do weigh-ins now when I really see a big difference. So my future videos are gonna be more so like challenges that I do, or just updating you here and there, but actually doing a dedicated weigh-in video won't happen anymore, just because I feel like it's a little repetitive and there's not big of a difference each time. But yeah, if you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up, as well as if you'd like to follow me on my journey, because I am on a journey to lose weight, y'all can hit the subscribe button down below. And also don't forget to hit the notification bell button so you get notified every time I upload a video. Yes. You can also follow me on all my social media links, which will be the linked down below and at the end of this video. I hope you guys have a wonderful day, and I'll see you all in my next video. Love you guys. Bye.